I met him first, say, in 1929 through the intervention of a friend of my common friend who asked Mr. Gandhi to see me, you see. And so Mr. Gandhi wrote to me saying that he would like to see me. So I went and saw him. That was just before going to the roundtable conference. And then he came to the second roundtable conference, didn't come for the first. And he was there for about 5-6 months. And there, of course, I met him also and faced him also, you see. Then, at once thereafter, he also, after the signing of the Pune Pact, you see, asked me to come and see him. So I went to see him. He was then in jail. You see, but that's all the time that I have met him. But I always say that as I met Mr. Gandhi in the capacity of an opponent, I have a feeling that I know him better than most other people because he had opened his real fangs to me, you see, and I could see the inside of the man, you see, while others who generally went there as devotees, you see, saw nothing of him except the external appearance which he had put up as a Mahatma, you see. But I saw him in his human capacity, the bare man in him. And so I say that I understand him better, you see, than most of the people who have associated themselves with him can say.
So how would you sum up what you found in him?
Well, I must say at the outset that I feel quite surprised, you see, at the interest which the outside world, Western world particularly, seems to be taking in Mr. Gandhi. I cannot understand that. So far as India is concerned, he was, in my judgment, you see, an episode in the history of India. Never an epoch maker. Gandhi has already vanished from the memory of the people in this country. His memory is kept up because the Congress Party annually, you see, gives a holiday either on his birthday or some other day connected with some event in his life, and has a celebration every year going on for 7 days in a week. Naturally, people's memory is revived. But if these artificial respirations were not given, I think Gandhi would be long, long, long.